Hey, you guys. The continual saga of my crazy, stressful week. Hopefully I'll do it in such a manner that it doesn't create stress for us tonight and still be relaxing, though full of drama. Say, where does the saga begin? Well, this is so stressful. It's a money thing. You guys will just never believe it. Last week, I don't even know how many days now, there was a deposit we made into an account of like 900 and some odd dollars. You know, a handful of different checks. Oh, before we go any further, my drink of the day is my kombucha, guava, goddess, delicious, and my noodle of the day is leftover cup noodles. Isn't that crazy? I thought it used to be called cup of noodles or cup o noodle. It was brought to my attention that real name on the label is cup noodles. Crazy. But I've dressed it up with these little Brussels sprouts. And chopped up little pieces of meatballs. Both frozen. Crazy. So, back to the money chaos. It'll be before Christmas. Oh my goodness. The good news is we have other money to get very easily, get the $900 cash. But when you make a deposit and you're expecting the deposit to go through like the next day, it was a mobile deposit. It didn't go through. I called and they said, oh, no worries, ma'am. Excuse me. I guess because it was a Friday, they said it'll come in on a Monday. I don't know. So sure enough, bigger than beans, it was not in. Comes to find out, it was now that it's on a 7-day hold, and they gave no rhyme or reason. It wasn't even like one big check. It was $900, and it was like a handful of checks. Like $200, $150, like $100, you know. Just a handful of little checks. Crazy. All they would say is it's on a 7 business days. So you know that's longer than 7 days. Guess when it's going to be released? The day after Christmas. And I was screaming bloody murder to them on the phone at the top of my lawn, and I said, that's my Christmas. Excuse me. That lady was so nice, and her heart was broken. She said, oh, I'm so sorry. And I said, so now what'll I do? And excuse me, I'm so sorry, you guys. And so I said, we've been banking with you guys for years and years. This has never happened to us. Now what's going on? And all she could offer was because of the fires, and this I do know is true, many of their branches were closed, and the main branch in Ventura County is like the head honcho branch that kind of is in charge of all the branches, and hey, this is kind of better left over. I kind of like these noodles better left over with my own and my own things in it. So she said, all I know is we have had a lot of trouble with other people and their it was mobile deposits. And she said, all I can offer you is our system is struggling. We have a lot of people. We're shorthanded because I do believe a lot of the people had fire issues and they just weren't able to get to work, number one, or their house was burning. It was just terrible. So I did understand that. But still, it didn't make my cash show up on my account. That is upsetting. So that's the bad news. But the good news is we do have other cash to get, so that's not a problem. But my heart just broke thinking there's somebody having that same trouble, and they don't have other money to get. Can you imagine? Oh my goodness. Have that happen to your Christmas money? Oh my goodness. It reminded me to count my blessings and be thankful. And I'm finding I'm doing a lot of that lately. Excuse me. I'm finding I'm doing a lot of like flipping my lid and then taking a couple steps back. Oh my goodness. Always be worse, and then I say like a little prayer for who's ever suffering. Even though I don't know who it is, my heart breaks for them because I'm sure that has happened to people, and it could be happening to them also for all I know. I do know that banks, they will put a hold like on anything like over $5,000, I think. I don't know what the number is. Oops. But that's expected. You know that's their rule, and you know you're going to be stuck without. I'm not happy with that, but at least you know the rules up front. Then, okay, well, there's that. That just happened the week before Christmas. Then, I thought I was going to do my daughter like this really big helpful thing. I owed her some money, so I went to the bank, deposited her money, and I said, oh, I'm going to deposit some of it in cash, because if you put cash, if you go to the lobby window and you give them cash, they'll put that money in your checking account right away. Bigger than beans, I no sooner walk in and I'm trying to deposit some cash, and they say, do you have an account with us? I said, no, this is my daughter's. And they kept asking me about me. I said, no, this is my daughter's account. Third time she said, well, I understand, ma'am, but we need to know At which point, I was just about to flip my lid. And I said, I'm sorry, I am so frazzled already. I do not understand. Why are you asking me about if I have an account here? I do not. Whatever that has to do with my deposit to my daughter's account, I'm just frazzled why you are insistent to know if I also have an account. She says, well, I'm sorry, ma'am. We cannot accept cash from anybody unless they have an account through our bank. Oh, my goodness. If you don't think I wanted to grab her face and just punch her. That's terrible. And it was only because I wanted so much to be nice to my daughter and give her some cash that I had owed her. She was so nice. She'd always buy us stuff from Costco. And I'd always pay her in cash because she'd come here pretty often, but she doesn't come here as often, so I realized, like, I've owed you this cash for weeks now. So my heart was to get that cash in there for her so she could have it right away. And the lady would not take my cash. I have had issues with, oh my goodness, we almost had another blooper. There goes my, but I'll stand. So I have had the same issue with this bank before and cash. In fact, if you search for my videos online, and I will say it was a Chase bank, and I guess I'm giving you like a heads up. I did a video once or twice about Chase Bank not accepting my money or something, I don't know. But it seems like I've done a couple of videos not happy with them. And the reason I'm mentioning it, so it's a heads up, I don't like to be mean. I don't like to be mean and just drop names and say something mean, but that is really hard to understand when they have options. Like, they could take my fingerprints, they could take my driver's license number, they could take my picture, they could do all this stuff to confirm that my cash is real cash. No, I don't like that either, but to just think it's okay to tell somebody we can't accept your cash, I don't know what to think of that. That's unsettling. So anyway, just know, if you want to do a good deed for a friend or a family member and get cash into their account right away, go to the lobby with cash in hand, and then you bank with them, you're not going to be able to give them your cash. Mm-mm. Terrible. Okay, so, oh my goodness, I forgot my digestive enzymes. Sorry, I can't believe it. And we have a new one we got from Amazon. It protects against, like, 18 different digestive issues. We've upgraded from the other essential enzyme brand. So, where am I here? So, then, if you may have noticed, did you notice my camera stamp? My camera just about did, I almost had another blooper. This camera stand was like a $25 or $30 item from Amazon that I love. Wow. Excuse me, I use it every day. I think I've used it so much that it's not staying in the position that I put it in. A lot of times I notice the camera falls forward or falls back or falls to one side like it just did. Sure. That's unsettling. I did not expect that to happen with everyday use. Unless there's a screw. I do see like little screws, so I'm wondering, do you have to tighten it and make the adjustments tighter? But knowing me, I'll grab my duct tape and I'll duct tape everything in place. But still, it's another issue that has to be addressed. Something I use every day. Oh, I just need things to go. I just need things to roll smooth like butter. I can probably handle things more easily if it just wasn't this week before Christmas. What was the other thing? I'm a little, you know, I don't want to be sad, but I know it's getting towards that time when my sister and my brother-in-law will be moving a few hours north, in which case I will not be seeing my little niece every week. And I realize when I really take a moment and realize the depth of that, that's a little sad. And so we were making plans, and so my sister and her husband and my little niece, we're going to have just, and our family have a little teeny tiny Christmas Eve gift exchange get together here, which will be nice. And then by the first week of January, or the beginning of the second week of January, they'll be moved, and we won't see them for 4 or 6 weeks, because she'll be coming back like every 4 to 6 weeks, because they still have their house here in town. But so what else popped up yesterday that was, I had a stressful moment, but I figured it out. Thank goodness I talked to my sister about it, and she helped me out. I have been trying to turn off all the Wi-Fi in the house at night. You know, after we're done with all our stuff, instead of just going to bed and leaving the Wi-Fi on when it's really time to go to sleep, I think it's healthier to have it off. And then I worried about my phone and got kind of panicked, because then I wouldn't receive emergency text alerts. And my daughter even asked, and I tried to pretend like it didn't bother me, but it really bothered me. So I was stressed out a couple nights about that. But I found out, and I'll share this with you in case you're thinking about doing the same thing. Wi-Fi goes horizontal. When you have a Wi-Fi shooting out Wi-Fi rays, radiation, it goes horizontally throughout those. If you have a cell phone with a cell phone carrier, the cellular reception goes up and down. Now, I haven't checked it out for myself online, but it made sense. So last night, I left my cell phone on with just the cellular connection, and I set it far, far across the room in between the sinks. We have like a double sink. I thought, okay, it's not too close that I'm going to feel like it's bothering me, but if there's an emergency, I'll hear it. Can you believe I tossed and turned for like 2 hours, and I got so upset, and I said, this is a bunch of baloney. I'm tossing and turning. I bet the cellular rays are hitting me, and that's why I can't sleep. but I was wrong. I was so focused on how I was gonna set up my phone to receive cellular connection vertically that though I shut off the Wi-Fi connection on my phone, I left the Wi-Fi on the main Wi-Fi on through the whole house. So once I figured that out, like at 1 a.m, I had a better night. So, but I would encourage you guys, if you are having trouble with the sleeping consistently through the night, like if you keep waking up every few hours, you may want to experiment and cut off your electrical connections. Did you know they even said a cordless telephone? Like if you're sleeping close to a cordless telephone, that's even bad. And I believe it. So, that's what's going on with that. My nighttime effort towards a better sleep. And on nights when there is absolutely no Wi-Fi is plugged in, I have been sleeping better. So I'm still testing out my theory. You know, I'm wondering if it's in my brain. Like when I go to the Wi-Fi and I unplug it, I not only just turn it off, I unplug completely, get it away and unplug it. You know, is it just the placebo effect? Am I thinking it's going to make me sleep better so I sleep better? Or is it really helping me to sleep better? And I think in my heart, I really do believe that without those electronic magnetic fields running around, I think I'm sleeping better. Anyways. So, when the wind started up again, now the only difference is it's still dry, very dry out. We need to have like a really good rain. It's really dry out. The winds whipped up big time, and I opened the front door mistakenly, thinking I had a package on the porch, and it's like icy cold wind whipping around. So that's another terrible thing for the fire. Which are like, I do believe they said now, yesterday, before the winds started back up again, they were real positive and said 60% contained. But they warned everybody that may change because the wind is expected to come back bigger, better than ever. And sure enough, it did. So I haven't even turned the TV on yet this morning because I couldn't take any more, add any more stress to it. What else? Last night my daughter called. Mom, guess who's sick? So my one daughter, she lives like a few hours away. Her plan was she was going to be at our house on Christmas Day. So there's a huge possibility he may not be here on Christmas Day. There's a huge possibility our Christmas Day may come and go without. It'll be like the Grinch that stole Christmas. There'll be no corn poppers, no razzle toys, no noise, no nothing, because I'll have my little niece. them if they're family on Christmas Eve, but for Christmas Day, our Christmas Day, it sounds like, won't be celebrated until December 29th at my mom's house. Crazy. But, of course, I don't want my daughter near us if she's sick, and I do want her to just stay home and cuddle up at home and get well. And, but, it's just crazy how things happen so fast, and you just think everything's gonna go as planned, and it doesn't. Oh, and the other glitch in the system is apparently my brother and sister have this ongoing drama that I never knew anything about. Remember my party planning sister, the one always in charge? That things may change in 2018 because she's moving far, far away. Possibly. So we've been trying to confirm stuff. She reached out to me. I guess my brother and her, they're real close in age, like a year and a half, who I thought got along really well growing up. But now as adults, oh my goodness, I guess they have like a subliminal war. I do not know what's going on. But she keeps trying to get a response from my brother to find out exactly what's happening, when the Christmas day, what day we'll be celebrating Christmas. And he won't respond. I don't know. And this has been going on forever. I just found out about it. And I didn't know we had that my adult siblings in their 50s. Can you believe that? So I guess yesterday it got so heated that my other sibling, she decided she was going to put a phone call into my brother and get things settled. So far, no word. I do not know how that ended up. Last night, my sister and her husband and my little niece were headed out to see the display of lights. You know how throughout the county or in each town they have the one spectacular house or street or area that's known for its awesome Christmas decorations. But they were off to the go view all the go down Main Street. They were doing that, so they stopped by for a moment, and I didn't dare want to mention so what's going on for me and ruin their fun evening last night. So perhaps we'll follow up with that today. And I'm still on kind of like limbo with some health issues with relatives and right before Christmas. Nope. That's like the worst time to be sick or have like a bad little blood lab work and have a bad result and be in limbo waiting for the doctor to call you back. Like the Thursday before Christmas. Oh my goodness. Just to say it out loud, that gets my stomach upset. I can't believe it. And that's usually what happens overly stressed. It all starts in my head, then it goes down to my stomach and I get an upset stomach, and then I'm in the bathroom all day. Terrible. But I try to make a little bit light of it, and I hope you've enjoyed this. I don't share too many crazy drama videos with you guys because honestly that's not my life, but every once in a great while it is kind of fun to share. I guess it's therapy for me. I get to talk about it. And so I hope I've been able to bring this to you in an entertaining way, even though it is drama and stressful. I'm hoping you were able to see the lighter side of my stress and how I'm trying. That really is the best out for me
is to not be so critical of my doom and gloom or drama or whatever I may think is going on with me, and to always, always be thankful for the wonderful things in my life, and to know to be grateful, because it could always be worse, always. And anyways, here we are. What is today? The Thursday before Christmas. My monies won't be available until after Christmas. But see, again, I was able to get money from elsewhere, so it wasn't a disaster. But I do enjoy rambling video. I hope it's just been in some way has been helpful to somebody, but perhaps you can take your drama and find a way to not be so critical. But and it's hard. I know it's easier said than done. The other person can always say something, do this, do that. As I've been there, unless you've been there, nobody really understands it. You can have all the help in the world, but until we make it up in our mind, what are we going to do to help our own self get through our own? Thank goodness I'm here today this way than when I was in my 20s and 30s growing up. Oh my goodness. You wouldn't even recognize me. Like, I'm not even the same person. Oh, that's another video I can share. I could tell you about my very first panic attack, anxiety attack. You know why? Because it happened at Christmas time. I can't remember the year exactly. I do believe it was in the 90s, mid-90s. That would be a good rambling video, because it's a terrible anxiety story of somebody having their first panic attack. It is hysterical, though. I may have shared it before. I have to search my videos. I'm like, oh my goodness. It's really funny, the things I did when I think back on that. But yet, remember, I knew nothing about panic attacks or anxiety attacks. And when I was having it, I was sure that, bigger than beans, I'm having a heart attack in my 30s. Terrible. Anyways, a reminder, to feel free to give this video a thumbs up, to push the like button if you found it entertaining, relaxing, interesting, informational, educational, and share it with somebody. I really appreciate it. And thanks for watching.